I'm Dr. Becky Coats with TMJ Plus. Many patients have asked, what's the difference in a phone consultation versus coming in for an exam with me? A phone consultation basically confirms what you're already hearing, noises in your jaw, what you're feeling. I've had headaches for a long time. No one's been able to help me. I've seen a chiropractor, a neurologist, an ENT. My ears may be ringing. The back of my head hurts. I have shoulder and neck pain, and nothing is helping. Confirming what's going on, you can do that even on the self-assessment that's on our website to see if you have risk factors. Coming in for an exam is a totally different thing to confirm what is your condition, what's going on so you can halt the disease and destruction. The symptoms that you have probably aren't going to go away, and there's a reason. Diagnosing the reason is the next step. Let me show you what we do and look at in a 3D x-ray, which is most important for understanding your true diagnosis. In the screen here, it shows you different examples of what the TMJ joint looks like, which is on the side right in front of your ear. This is a normal TMJ. The bone looks nice and round like the top of a baseball. As you have the jaw fall back towards your ear in this position, you're back in the cave. Another progression is when the bone starts to change, it becomes more flat. Further progression is when it's flattening onto the top, kind of like somebody carved it off. Over here is when the bone is under so much stress from the muscle, it starts to actually bend. Usually at that point, that's when people feel like crunchy, munchy noises, or it feels like a cheese grater. Over here, the bone is bent so much, it's actually becoming restricted. And at this point, which is when people have waited too long, and they might wind up being a surgery case, is when the bone has so much degenerative changes, there are less options. So what does it look like on a 3D x-ray? What's the value of that? This is just a cartoon drawing showing the disease progression. Cone beam CT is used in our office to help aid with diagnosis. This is a TMJ joint looking straight on, like you're looking at yourself in the mirror. This is the sideways view, looking from ear to the front. What's the point of looking at this? The TMJ joint is further back in this cave. This opening right here is where you clean your ear with your Q-tip. So many people say, well, I've had like stuffy ears and I've had vertigo. Maybe they have meniere's been diagnosed loosely. Ringing of the ears, and they're tired of that spin cycle of pain. If you think about it this way, if the bone is pushed back towards your ear, in that space is tissues, such as the disc. It helps us slide. But there's also nerves that's connected to hearing. There's also blood vessels that if they're pinched and squished, they cause pain, soreness, and inflammation. After we help someone and we've been through diagnosis and options, this is what it should look like in space. If you can see the difference of less space, that gray space is exactly where tissue, blood vessels, and nerves are occupied. Here's the space after we help someone with TMJ treatment. Big difference, right? From the side view, most important, moving the TMJ and bite forward. What does that mean? Getting the bone away from bone, allowing space for the body to do what it's supposed to do and heal. Space for blood vessels, nerves not to be compressed, is what will resolve pain. This is what's important for you to come in for your exam with me, to be able to see the position of your spine, your head and neck, your teeth position, and also looking at your airway. That is one of the components of your exam with me, which is the radiograph component. Many people want to know, well, what does that look like in the mouth? This is an example of a TMJ orthotic to get relief immediately, to offer solutions that you've never had before. I'm Dr. Becky Coats with TMJ Plus, and I look forward to helping you with your exam soon.